Hello everyone, welcome to WebSense Pro, where you learn all of the tips and tricks related to Shopify, WordPress, web designing and development in general. So in this video, I will show you guys how you can add custom font to your Shopify store without touching any CSS code. Yes, you heard it right. You won't be needing any custom CSS coding to copy and paste. All you have to do is just tweak the settings in customize and you will be able to add custom font to your Shopify store. Super simple, super easy to learn. All you have to do is watch the full video. Let me know in the comments below if you found any instructions problem, and then I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Okay, so as you can see that on my store, I have refresh theme installed on my development store, and on menu, I have a different font, and on this heading, I have a different font, and this button is same as the menu font. And if I go to my customize settings, you can see I have this custom font option showing up, which isn't, by the way, available in default refresh theme. This tutorial is gonna work for all of the 12.0.0 themes, Dawn, Refresh, Sense, Spotlight. So basically all of the free themes in the Shopify store will support this code. You can also use this in paid theme, but it might not work properly. So better use that on free themes. But if you want help implementing that on paid theme, let me know in the comments below. Okay, so as you can see, I have these two font options, two font blocks, where I have defined the custom font. So that's my custom font, and that's the URL which I have added. So it supports OTF, WOFF, and WOFF2 formats, right? Now you can see that the font which the URL I have added, so it's Sauce Tomato font, which I downloaded from Free Fonts. So there's a website for free fonts. I downloaded that font, and after uploading it, I just pasted the URL here, and it's implemented on A tags only. So it's for menu. Now what if you want to target the custom CSS, like target the custom element? So what if I want to add this custom font to my announcement bar? Let me show you what you can do here. Is I'll go to the front end, and then I'll open the developer tools. You can open the developer tools by clicking on right click and then inspect. And from there, you will find the class. And all you have to do is just copy the class from here. So that's the class name where we want to target our custom font. So I'm just going to copy the class, add the class here, and the class is defined by adding the dot. So I'm just going to place a dot here, and you can see that my announcement bar font is updated now. Now if I just remove it, you can see it's reverted back to the default font. And now if I add the CSS selector again, you can see that the font is showing up. Cool, right? So you don't have to define it on CSS again and again about selecting the elements and defining the font family. All you can do is just add the CSS selector or select any of the selectors which are available in this customized settings. Cool, right? So now what I'm gonna do, I'll show you how you can create this section which we have in our customized setting here and benefit from this tutorial. Okay, so that's the tutorial which we'll be following. I'll put the link of this tutorial on YouTube video description, so you guys can easily copy and paste the code which will create the new section in our theme. Okay, now let's go back to the dashboard and let me install a fresh theme for you guys in order to show you guys if it works fine or not. So what I'm gonna do, I'll do that on fresh Dawn theme. So I have this Dawn 12.0.0 which I installed recently. There are no customization being done on this theme, so I'm just going to publish that one. Click on publish and then publish again. And what we're gonna do, we will just first initially we will need to upload the custom font files. And how we can do that, we can click on content and then click on files, and here we will just upload the files by clicking on upload files. And then you can upload the font. I have this font already uploaded. You can see Sauce Tomato OTF. So I have this font already uploaded here, right? Now we will create section on our theme. Let's go to online store and click on these three small dots and then edit code. Before editing the code, guys, make sure to have the backup of your theme. In case you're working on a live theme, it's better to have backup so you can easily revert back if you mess up anything on the code. Okay, now we will create a new section. So click on sections here and then click on add a new section. Before proceeding with the tutorial, guys, make sure to subscribe this channel. This will help us support, create more valuable content for you guys. Also, if you are new to Shopify and want to set up your new Shopify store for just $1 per month, there's a link in the description. If you sign up through that link, you will get this exclusive offer, which is just for my YouTube viewers, where you can set up a new Shopify store for just $1 per month for 3 months. So don't wait and just sign up. Okay, let's proceed with the tutorial. So I'm going to create a new section. The name of the section should be WebSense Pro dash custom dash font. So just copy this section name here and then paste it here. Cool. Click on done. And once our section is created, make sure to remove all of the existing code first and then copy the code which I have provided here. So all you have to do is just click on copy code and paste it here and then hit save. Okay, our next step is to include this section on our theme.liquid file. And how we can do that? We can do that by navigating to our theme.liquid file. So here's our theme.liquid file. And we will scroll down, or what we can do is press Command F if you are on a Mac, or Control F if you are on Windows, and search for body. And here, after the body element, we will just include the section which we added. And in order to include this section, you can just copy this code here and then paste it here and hit save. And that's it. We are done with our tutorial. Now all we have to do is just go to customize setting, copy and paste the font URL which we uploaded, and our custom font will be implemented. Let's go to our customize setting, click on these three small dots and then click on customize theme. And here you can see we have this new section created called custom font. We will just open that and then click on add font. Our font block is added now. Now you can name your font name to whatever you want. I have just added custom font here, or you can add whatever you want. We can decide what's the font weight which we need to set. We can go with normal, bold, or none, meaning it will automatically detect the font weight from the font family file. Okay, now in the font URL, we will copy the font family URL which we uploaded and paste it here. So I'm going to go to the content. Let's open that up on the new tab. And okay, I have the dashboard open. Now from the left hand menu, we have content and then files, where we already uploaded our font family. Here I have these four font families files which I already uploaded. So I'm just going to copy this last one, and there's a button here for the link. All you have to do is just click on this button and paste this URL to our custom font name here. So just paste it. And as you can see, our font family is updated to all of our theme. Click save and preview it. Click on these three small dots and then click on view. Okay, as you can see, our custom font has been implemented completely fine without any issue, and we didn't actually coded the CSS. We just created our new section which we can reuse whenever we want, and we can disable this as well. So if you go to customize settings and click on this custom font here, we have this option to enable and disable this custom font which we added. So all you have to do is just uncheck it and it will revert it back to the default font, or if you want it, you can simply enable it. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you guys like it. If you do, let me know in the comment below and let me know what more you would like to learn. We will definitely try to create as much tutorials as possible. Make sure to subscribe the channel. Until next video, have a great day.